I think that there are two topics. I think that, first of all, the technology using biomethane, natural gas, in the gaseous form or liquid form is ready. We work with almost all OEMs in Europe and worldwide on different solutions. And today, the performance of vehicles, LCV or truck running on biomethane is absolutely the same of any other technology. But it offers great advantage in terms of cost affordability and decarbonization of the transportation. I think, of course, we need to work on innovation, and this is what we are doing.
We are in a phase of media where the attention is focused very tunnel-like into electrification, which, as Cristiano has mentioned, has a wealth of benefits and advantages, but it's not a silver bullet. It's not a solution that fits everything and everybody. So I think we need to get over the frenzy and open the conversation towards a more diversified future, a future that has room for technologies such as biomethane, biogas, e-fuels, hydrogen, electrification, even diesel. I mean, we have to be able to take the best out of every available technology that will cumulatively get us where we need to get. And we don't necessarily have to jump in a single bullet train to do that.
The number one thing that I think that would help communicate the strength of biomethane and the story that natural gas has to play is getting away from looking at only tailpipe emissions and truly looking at well-to-wheel emissions. The positive greenhouse gas benefits that biomethane brings when you look at the well-to-wheel of a heavy-duty vehicle versus a heavy-duty vehicle powered off of electricity that could be from a coal-fired plant, massive benefits. Factors of 5, 6, 7x. Even so, if you look at biomethane in the future, on par with potentially blue and green hydrogen with a blend of fossil natural gas. The second part of that is I want to talk about technology that Cristiano mentioned a little bit. And from a natural gas standpoint, whether it's running on pure biomethane or a blend or fossil, the technology is there. There's no reason to wait today. And Europe has done a fantastic job of putting natural gas infrastructure in place. And the OEMs have done a good job of having factory available natural gas solutions for heavy duty long haul. So I would say the technology is there, the infrastructure is in place, the fuel is becoming cleaner every day from a natural gas perspective. And the question is really to the fleet is why wait?
Okay.
And the TCO is there as well from a cost of ownership.